Good morning. Here's what's coming up on Clive Scoop.
The Interboro Education Association is offering a scholarship to those interested in becoming a teacher, so we'll have details on that coming up.
You're watching IHS TV, Channel 11. And now, Barry Harris, Laura Boyd, and the K-Scope News team. This is Kaleidoscope News This Morning.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome back. Today is Monday, May 4th. I'm Laura Boyd.
And I'm Barry Harris. Well, welcome back. It's a pleasure to have you back here, Laura.
Yeah, it's nice to be back.
All right, we're going to start you off this morning with a look at the weather.
Hi, this is Steph with the weather. Today will be rainy with a high 56. Tonight, so it'll be 53. The current temperature is 54 degrees and humidity is at 95%. And the barometric pressure is at 30.03 and steady. And now to Berthy.
Hi, this is Sophie with the Berthys. The Berthys for today are Jeff Walsh, Brian Wenger, John Knott, Andrew Bach, Alex Oxner, and Amanda Schick. Happy birthday. Now over today's headline.
Good morning, this is Jess with today's headline. Governor Rendell announced yesterday Pennsylvania's first confirmed case of swine flu of a 31-year-old Mexican man who had recently arrived in Montgomery County. Now back to the news desk.
Here's the Buccaneers game of the week. The softball team will play home against Chichester on Wednesday at 3:30. Come out and show your support. The Interboro Education Association is offering two $1,000 scholarships to seniors who will major in education with the intention of becoming a teacher. Please see Mrs. Black for more information. The first mandatory practice session leading up to cheerleading tryouts will be today after school at 3:15. See Ms. Nowry or Ms. Lawrenson for more information. Now for sports.
Good morning, this is Allie and Jim with today's sports.
Girls lacrosse team takes on Sun Valley tonight away. JV is at 5 and varsity is at 7:30.
The softball team goes up against St. Hubert's today at home at 3:45.
Phillies play tonight in St. Louis against the Cardinals at 8:15.
That's it for sports. Now over to the news desk.
As always, if you have an announcement for us to read on the air on Kaleidoscope, please send a hard copy to Mr. Nunley to ensure that we receive it. Congressman Joe Sestak will be holding a Veterans Summit Wednesday at 9 p.m. at Ridley High School. We want to pass that information along to any interested community members. Don't miss the junior class trip to Baltimore, Maryland. Permission slips and money is due on May 6th to Ms. Nowry. And finally, the yearbook is almost here. They will be arriving very shortly, and you can reserve your yearbook from Mrs. Schwartz, Mr. Pattinson, or Mrs. Powers in the main office. And to celebrate, we're going to look back at an old K-Scope promo. This aired back when Mr. Mullen used to run the TV studio. This is from the early 80s, I believe. Take a look at this. Now we turn our attention to the menu item of the day.
Hi, this is Nick with the menu. Today we'll have cheesy beefaroni with carrots, peaches, and a dinner roll. And tomorrow we'll have barbecue chicken with seasoned rice, green beans, and chilled fruit cocktail. And now over to the vocab word.
Good morning, everybody. This is Colin with the vocab word of the day. Today's vocab word is juxtaposition, meaning the act of placing two things next to each other for implicit comparison. For example, the juxtaposition of these two kids is one is wearing a green shirt, one is wearing a red shirt. Now to Kim with the quote of the day.
This is Kim with the quote of the day. Louis Neiser once said, when a man points a finger at someone else, he should remember that four of his fingers are pointing back at himself. Now over to this day in history.
This is Chris with This Day in History. On this date, May 4th, 1626, Dutch explorer Peter Minuit landed on Manhattan Island. Native Americans later sold the island for $24 in cloth and buttons. And in 1715, French manufacturer debuted the first folding umbrella. In 1932, Al Capone entered the Atlanta Penitentiary Federal Prison System for tax evasion. Now over to trivia.
This is Brooke with the trivia. Did you know that the Eiffel Tower has 1,792 steps?
That's it, everyone. Thanks for watching Kaleidoscope. I'm Laura Boyd.
And I'm Barry Harris. Well, it's a pleasure having you with us today. Good day and good luck.